What's good, y'all? It's the one and only NY Phenom. If you guys enjoy NFL NBA content, give this video a like. And if you're new, go and subscribe to the channel while you're at it. Now, let's get to it. Listen. Let's speak about these week one previews slash predictions slash betting odds, man. Let's speak on it. It's great to have NFL football back. We made it to week one. Just watched the Chiefs and Texans game yesterday. So we're officially back, baby. So, you know, let's go ahead and let's jump into these predictions. And let's go and start with the Bears and Lions. All right, listen. I'm rocking with the Lions. You guys should know this. The Lions are a playoff team this year. The Bears stink. They suck. Mr. Biscay's a bum. Matt Nagy is not going to be able to scheme open plays for Mr. Biscay consistently. They have no running game. They only have one receiver. Jimmy Graham is a corpse. I mean, I don't see why people would think that this Bears team has a chance with this Lions team. This Lions team got weapons for days. Matthew Stafford's coming back. He's a top 10 quarterback. They drafted Jeff Okuda. Matt Patricia back is against the wall. Same for Matthew Stafford. It's a home game for Detroit. I know there's not going to be fans there, but at the end of the day, you got to lean with the Lions. They're a better team. They're going to have Kenny Golladay. Well, hopefully, because there were some reports talking about Kenny Golladay might miss this game. So who knows how that plays out. But most likely it's going to play. So you got Golladay, Marvin Jones, TJ Hawkinson is going to be a beast. I mean, my only concern about this game is the Lions offensive line. If this Lions offensive line is average at best, if they can just be average, the Lions win this game by 14 points. There's no way Mitch Trubisky is going to keep up with Matthew Stafford. Fuck out of here. So I would probably touch this game. The Lions are 3-point favorites. I'll probably touch that game just because the Lions are a better team. But at the end of the day, it's a division game. I'm big on the Lions, but I know a lot of people aren't. So you can touch that game if you want. If you're as optimistic as I am about the Lions, then I would probably touch 3 points. But we'll see how things play out. Listen, Raiders at Panthers. I'm not really going to speak on it. I got the Panthers winning this game. They're 3-point favorites. I wouldn't touch the game because it's the Panthers. The Panthers are probably going to go 5-11, 6-10 at best. But it's a home game. It's in Carolina. I think Teddy Bridgewater can put up some points with the talent around him. I think they win this game. You know, maybe Derek Carr puts up points for his team because this Panthers defense is trash, garbage, they stink, they suck. But at the end of the day, I'm going to roll with the home team, all right? Packers at Vikings. Let me speak on this. Why is the Vikings the favorite going to this game? Can somebody please explain to me why the Vikings are the favorite going to this game? I got the Packers winning. Now, while I touch the betting odds, you know, the Vikings are a 2.5 favorite. Now, yeah, they're the home team, but there won't be no fans in the crowd. I told you guys that this was a traditional NFL season where there's fans. I can see why the Vikings are the favorite. You know, M&T Bank Stadium, they be rocking, they be loud. You know, it's one of the littest stadiums in the entire, you know, sports country. You know, this is where it is. But at the end of the day, it's like no fans. This defense got a lot worse. You got a new secondary, new young secondary with new pieces. Just lost Everson Griffin. Daniel Hunter is out for this game. Yes, Daniel Hunter is out for this game. I know they moved for Yannick. They traded for Yannick Ngakoue. But Yannick Ngakoue as a number one edge rusher doesn't scare me. Especially when he's going to most likely be matched up against David Bakhtiari. So you know he's not going to touch the quarterback. He's not going to touch Aaron Rodgers. I mean, how do the Vikings win this game? The only way I can see the Vikings win this game is if Dalvin Cook falls. And maybe that's the case because this Packers run defense suck. But give me Aaron Rodgers. Give me Davante Adams versus terrible cornerback room. I love the Vikings safeties. Harrison Smith, Anthony Harris, they're studs. But come on now. Really? Aaron Jones, AJ Dillon, they'll run the ball up the middle. And I think this Packers defense overall, if they can stop the run, they should handle business. The Vikings don't scare me as an offensive unit. I love me some Kirk Cousins, but he just lost his number one outside weapon in Stephon Diggs. All right, they had Stephon Diggs and Adam Thielen, then we could talk. But it's just Adam Thielen. And I trust Jaire Alexander to travel him around the field and, contain Adam Thielen. I do. So at the end of the day, give me the Packers. I'll probably even take the 2.5 points. 2.5 points is risky, but you might as well. It's just 2.5 points. You might as well take it. So give me the Packers. Jets and Bills. Not going to even speak on this. Listen, Bills win. If the Bills lose to the fucking Jets at home, I will never forget the Bills. I might just throw the Bills in the firing range. If Josh Allen goes out and loses that Jets team, he's going to the fire range. I'm picking this Bills team as my eliminator. So if the Bills let me down and lose this game, that means I'm already losing out on 100K. Fuck y'all. Bills, listen, do not lose. Do not lose to these pathetic Jets. The Jets are just as bad as the Jaguars. Do not lose to the Bills. Dolphins at Patriots. Cam Newton debut. It's going to be a lot of fun. Give me Superman Cameron Belichick, man. They're 6.5 favorites. I know the Dolphins, they're improving. They're rebuilding. They're looking good. But they're not ready to mess with Belichick and Cam Newton. And not to mention, the Dolphins literally and low-key just messed up a Patriots title run last year. If Brady and the Patriots were to beat the Dolphins last year like they were supposed to do in the home finale, they would not play in the wild card round. And maybe they won't match up with the Titans in the second round. So at the end of the day, Stephon Gilmore and the crew is going to come motivated because Devontae Parker took a shit on Stephon Gilmore the last game of the season. So Stephon Gilmore got something to prove. He's the best corner in the NFL. I don't see how Ryan Fitzpatrick moves the ball down the field unless they run the ball. I actually think the Dolphins running game is going to be amazing with Jordan Howard and Matt Breida. So maybe the Dolphins could keep it competitive. So maybe don't take in the 6.5 points. But at the end of the day, don't bet against Cam Newton and Belichick. Cam Newton and Belichick is definitely going to win the game. Will they win it by 6.5, 7 points? I don't know. Just because it's a division game, and the Dolphins are always competitive with the Patriots. So at the end of the day, give me Cam Newton. I'm rocking with Superman Cam. Colts and Jaguars, take the fucking points. Ain't nothing to speak about. Listen, this game was going to be a blowout, obliteration, annihilation. Listen, let me tell y'all something real quick. If you got Phillip Rivers in your fantasy drafts, start him, okay? If you got T.Y. Hilton in your drafts, start him, okay? If you got Jonathan Taylor, Marlon Mack, hell, Nakeem Hines, start them all. This Colts team is beating the Jaguars by 40 points. They're going to blow out the Jaguars by 40 points. Maybe even 50. This game is going to be bad. If you're a Jaguars fan, close your eyes. Okay, I don't care if it's in Jacksonville. I don't care y'all. You and the Chiefs are the only teams that can carry 22% of y'all fans in the game. I don't give a fuck. This Jaguars team suck. Gardner Minshew, he's average at best. He has no talent around him outside DJ Turk and Westbrook. This team is bad. No offensive line, no defense. Colts are from the they're gonna send the Jaguars to another dimension after this game. Unbelievable. Take the Colts. I want the 8 points. That's easy money. I'm gonna just tell you right now, the Colts won by 40 points. I'm not even kidding. I'm being dead serious. The Colts are gonna win by 40 points. Listen, y'all remember that game from last year, week one? Ravens versus Dolphins. First game. It's gonna be like that. Oh, it's gonna be like that. Phillip Rivers from the throw for like 5 touchdowns. Jonathan Taylor from the getting end zone. Same for Marlon Mack. Michael Pittman is gonna get in the end zone. Same for T.Y. Hilton. This game is gonna be a Jaguars don't stand a chance. Eagles at Washington. I'm not gonna touch this game at all. Eagles are the favorite, but I'm not touching this game at all. From all reports, Eagles offensive line has been looking garbage all season, all training camp long. We know the Redskins' biggest strength is going to be their defensive line and pass rush. I'm not touching this game at all. I'm not liking what's going on with the Eagles. Alshon Jeffery is out already. He's already injured. Jalen Reagor's already injured. I don't believe in Miles Sanders in a 3-down. But you guys know, I don't believe in the Eagles at all this year. I had the Eagles going 6-10. We know the Washington football team, they're a joke. They had to change their name. They don't have a name. Both of these teams are a joke. So I'm not touching this game. 5.5 points. I know a lot of people are going to tell you, jump on the Eagles. This is easy money. I'm not touching this game at all. Not touching it. Not touching it at all. All I'm touching is Zach Ertz, because I think Zach Ertz eats this game. That's the only thing I'm saying. Everything else, no, I'm sitting away from. Not betting this game at all. I'll just take the Eagles just because, but that's an upset alert. That's an upset alert. If the Washington football team were to win that game, I wouldn't be shocked. Let's just say it like that. If the Washington football team, if Haskins were to go out and ball on his sorry ass Eagles defense, it wouldn't shock me at all. Let's just put it like that. Chargers at Bengals, give me the Chargers. I'm not speaking on this. Jim Burrow, I'm not a believer. And I think the Chargers defense can match up with the Bengals offensive weapons. Cardinals at Niners, give me the Niners. Cardinals are the most overrated team in the NFL. They're not a playoff team. Kyler Murray is not an MVP contender. Give me the Niners. Niners going to run all over this sorry Cardinals run defense. Isaiah Simmons is not physical enough to be an inside linebacker. Y'all trying to tell me Isaiah Simmons and Patrick Queen is better linebackers than Jordan Brooks, but I don't see it. Isaiah Simmons should be playing strong safety, but that's neither here or there. So I think they give me the Niners. It's at home. Give me the Niners. Cowboys at Rams. I'm going to rock with the Rams. I think the Rams win this game. And I'll probably take... The Rams, they're going to be bad this year. But this is a game that I have to win it. I'm not touching the point spread at all. Because the Rams could fall on their face. Cowboys are the better team. They are. They got better weapons. Dak is better than Jared Goff. I get it. And by the way, salute to Dak. Salute to Dak. Expressing his mental illness. Listen, A lot of quarterbacks will be scared to do that, but Dak showing that he was a leader. And fuck Skip Bayless. Y'all trying to tell me that this doesn't make Dak more of a leader? Fuck out of here. I don't got time for that. Anyway, give me the Rams. It's a home game. I know there's not gonna be fans there, but Cowboys still have to travel to LA. I'm just saying, they still gotta travel to LA. So I mean, the Rams can have somewhat of a home field advantage. All right, so at the end of the day, give me Jared Goff. I think it's going to be one of the rare games that Jared Goff actually balls out. The Cowboys secondary is iffy. As long as the Rams offensive line can keep Everson Griffin, DeMarcus Lawrence away from Jared Goff, then the Rams should win this game. I expect Robert Woods and Cooper Kupp to eat. So give me the Rams, all right? And then last game, give me the Steelers. I'm not taking the 6-point spread because I think Daniel Jones and Joe Judge is going to make this game super competitive. I'm big on the Steelers. I think the Steelers go 12-4 this year. But at the end of the day, all reports I'm hearing, Joe Judge, he got these Giants players right. He got these Giants players playing disciplined, and I think this Giants team is going to be the most disciplined Giants team we've seen since Tom Coughlin was coaching. So at the end of the day, I like this Giants team. I'm not touching the point spread. I get it. The Steelers are 6-point favorites, but I'll take the Steelers to win the game. I think Big Ben and his defense squeaks it out, because I just don't think Daniel Jones has enough weapons on the outside Darius Slayton and maybe Sterling Shepard, depending on how you feel about Sterling Shepard, to make enough players to win this game. But at the end of the day, I can see this game being a 24-20 game. Daniel Jones making a few good plays, but I don't think it's gonna be good enough. This Steelers team is a top 5 defense. Big Ben is back. I'll take them to win the game. I'm just not taking the point spread. I just think the Giants are gonna keep this game way too close. I think they're gonna keep it very close. So at the end of the day, man, this is the week 1 point spread, my betting odds, my preview, my predictions. Oh, if you didn't see your team, If you want to see your teams, me breaking down your teams, it's because I'm going to make a separate video on it. I'm making a separate video, of course, on my Seahawks and Falcons. Of course, we're going to talk Bucks and Saints. And of course, the two other teams, two other games I didn't cover, I'm making a separate video on that. That's all I really got to say, man. That's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm the Phenomenal One, and I'm out. Deuces.
To have bad luck, now you might see me in the Jag truck, masked up, even with a dime or a bad duck.